Ariel Helwani in New York City gearing up for UFC 230 alongside Sajara Eubanks, who meets Roxanne Modafferi this Saturday on the prelims at Madison Square Garden. Sajara, I just have to ask, first things first, are we okay? I feel like you're mad at me. I'm not sure. I want to squash the beef. Where are we at?
Listen, let's squash the beef because I got bigger beef to handle on Saturday. So me and you are going to squash the beef. All I'm saying is y'all could have respected my position as the headlining fight of Madison Square a little bit better. All I'm saying, what you didn't know is that I was going to put on a hell of a show fighting Valentina as the headline November 3rd. And then everybody would have ate their hats the next day. But alas, we're here. We're fighting Roxanne. I'm still going to put on a hell of a show. But don't worry. We'll be all right.
I'm happy to hear that. I'm happy that there's no beef anymore. Is it hard being here when you had that title fight, you had that main event slot, and it was taken away from you, and now you're still on the card, but you're obviously not in the main event slot? Is it hard to wrap your head around it?
No, I'm still having a blast. I'm in Madison Square Garden. Like, how do you not have fun in New York, for one? For two, like, this is still an opportunity. My ultimate goal, like I've said it a million times, my ultimate goal is to be UFC Women's Flyweight Champion. I'm going to get that gold belt. So I thought I had the shot, but we've been rerouted to Roxanne, and so I got to focus on Roxanne. I got to beat Roxanne on November 3rd in order to keep my trajectory towards that belt. So I just took it as one door closes, another one opens. Let's have some fun. Let's have a good time. I got a few extra bucks out the deal. I get to fight in my own backyard. You know, Mark Henry doesn't even have to get on a plane. He could drive up. So we're good to go. We're going to have a blast.
What was the official reason that you were given as to why they made that decision, why they made the switch?
We do this kind of thing all the time. No,
come on.
Seriously, they didn't give me a reason. They were like, well, we did it to Joanna. I was like, screw Joanna. I don't care what you did to Joanna.
Two wrongs don't make a right.
Yeah, I was like, I don't care, for one. For two, yeah, two wrongs don't right. We weren't given a good reason, but I concluded that Derek's post-fight speech was just way too cool, and his balls bumped me from the headline. That was it. Derek dropped his shorts, and I got dropped to FS1. It is what it is.
You actually spoke to Dana White, though, right?
Yes, I did.
How was that?
I screamed at him a little bit. Second time I screamed at Dana, I realized now I kind of have a pattern. But maybe I'm a spoiled brat. I tend to get my way after I kick and scream a little bit. But, I spoke to Ali first, and Ali kind of was like, man, sorry, kid. I was like, get Dana on the phone. He's like, you know, he doesn't talk to fighters. I was like, he going to talk to me. I want to know what's going on here. And then I told him, I was like, you passing up on a Rocky moment. I was going to come in here. I was going to shock the world. I was going to put Valentina on our ass in front of all these fans in New York City. And it was going to be a blast. And not only did you take my dream from me, but you took, it was about to be epic out here. And he was like, he loved my fire. He loved the way I talked to him. And he was like, all right, let's try to do some things. We'll keep him on the card. And at first I was like, you know, at first I was pissed. I was like, screw the whole card. Screw you guys. But he called me back and then got Ali, a bunch of stuff went back and forth, and they came back with Roxanne and a new contract, and I was like, all right.
So you got paid at least.
I did. I did get paid at least.
It's not all for naught.
I said, I got a daughter, man. Christmas is coming up. How are you going to do this to me? And I hate these big gaps between fights. I haven't fought since June 3rd. So to be able to stay on the November card, because I was supposed to fight Jessica Eye, and I asked her, I was like, let's do November, and she was like, let's do December, and I was like, make me wait forever. So now I'm back on the same card I always wanted to be on anyway. So,
when was the first time you got mad at Dana and screamed at him?
At the Ultimate Fighter, because they had me ranked 12. And so when I tapped my Eva Stevenson, I went up to the thing. It was like 12, 12. And then every fight I won in the Ultimate Fighter, I went up to him and was like, I told you, you my ranking up. And
keep disrespecting you.
Yeah, over and over again. When are you going to learn? I don't know.
So have they told you that if you win this fight, you're fighting the winner of Joanna and Valentina?
Yes, but I got a verbal agreement. They didn't send me a contract this time on that, but they said.
Believe them?
I'm going to believe them. Why not? Keep my hopes up. And then if they mess around me again, I'll just scream and yell, and I'll just fight again, and I'll keep winning until I get my shot.
Do you feel like you're going into this fight with a bit of a chip on your shoulder? Because, you know, you were disrespected, right, by a lot of people when it was put as the main event. You feel like, okay, I need to now shut these people up. I need to prove to them that I am main event worthy, that I should be fighting for the belt, that I shouldn't be talked about this way. Is that part of your psyche heading into the fight?
A small bit of my psyche. The chip on my shoulder, but in a healthy way. Sort of like a motivation, like, man, y'all done pissed me off now. I'm really going to have to lay some hands on somebody here. I'm going to have to let y'all know it's dangerous. But I always want to put on a show. I always want to go for the finish. I always want to improve my skills as a martial artist every time I step out there. So a little bit of motivation, a little bit of, hey, I'm still on a big stage. The attention's on me. It's still hot. So let's take advantage of the light while we got it.
So you win on Saturday night. They announce you as the winner. Joe Rogan walks in the cage for the post-fight interview. What happens then?
He's going to hear from me, for sure. I won't tell you what I got planned, but he'll hear.
You got something planned?
Yeah. You guys will see. You'll know. Joe will know.
Have you been thinking about this a lot?
Not a lot, but I have thought about it from time to time. As part of my, I always visualize my post-fight thing, and I'm a nerd. I kind of practice my post-fight interviews anyway, and so part of my winning process. And so, yeah, no, I'm going to, Joe, I'm going to let him know.
Something tells me he knows you now.
Yeah, he absolutely knows me now. I feel like somewhere he's like, God, I just can't wait for Joe to be like, oh, she won. I can't wait.
It'll be a great moment. Best of luck to you in the fight. Looking forward to it.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Ariel.